Let's be honest, getting people's attention is hard. But you know what's even harder? Getting the attention of people who are at the C-suite level or even a public figure. Sending an email might sound like the easy and great way to get everyone's attention, but I think we all know that everyone's inboxes are so full today, and it's probably very likely that your message might get sent to the bottom of that inbox. So how do you get someone to respond to these cold emails? Well, fortunately for us, we are joined by Gloria Chow, who is a PR expert, and she's also a Career Contessa alumni. Gloria, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me. You know, last time I was here, you profiled me because I was a U.S. diplomat, and now I'm in PR, so that is a huge transition.
Yes.
But I will tell you that throughout all my transitions, cold calling people, getting clients, pitching to journalists, I really developed this method, and it's really proven to be successful. I actually got the Colorado governor to show up to a tech event that I organized using this method, and I've never even been to Colorado.
That's amazing. Well, we are so excited to have you here, and we are ready to learn. Let's do it. Hi, Contessas. Welcome back. I'm Lauren McGoodwin, founder and CEO of Career Contessa, the only career site built inclusively for women. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel because we drop videos weekly. And we want to hear from you. How do you get people to respond to your emails? Let us know in the comments below. All right, so let's dive into your three-step method, the CPR method, and tell us a little bit about what this is.
So the main goal here when you're making the ask is you're not really asking for anything. What you're trying to do is show them how you can add value. And that's what I'm going to show you with the CPR method and adding value every step of the way.
Okay, so step number one is C for credibility in the CPR method. So tell us about that.
So when you first reach out to someone, it's really important to establish yourself and your own credibility. So how do you show that you're a vetted person? You can highlight your work experience. You can highlight the areas you've made some significant impact. But if you're a new grad, you probably don't have that much to show, in which case C can stand for connection.
I love that.
Play the connection card. Maybe you've been to the same conference where that person spoke at, or maybe you've read this book and you think it's applicable to X, Y, and Z. Something that pulls you guys a little closer so you're not just some random person, and maybe someone that this person might run into in the future.
Yeah, I think really bridging the gap with the commonality is super, super, super important, and something people kind of just assume maybe the other person already knows. They're not going to know it, so you need to connect the dots for them.
100%.
Okay, so step two in the CPR method is P for point of view. So tell us about that.
So this is really important because here's where you can get really intentional about your ask. You're basically showing the person that you're intentional enough to do research on the topic and mm-hmm. form an opinion about it.
I love this because basically most people make a pitch and they're like, here's what's happening, come talk to me about it, or come talk to us about it, or show up to this event. But when you throw data and research into it and you have this point of view, it's really impressive, and most people don't do that. So it kind of shows that you actually really do care about the topic too.
Exactly. So if you're, for example, asking a CEO to speak on a panel about women in the workplace, maybe talk a little bit about the crisis that we're having, there's not too many women in the C-suite, something like that.
Yeah, and it really will bring them more emotionally tied into the topic as well.
Yep.
Okay, so step three is reach. Let's talk about that.
So this is where you get to take the conversation beyond just you and that person. You're saying, hey, it's not just me asking to meet with you. It's me and my classmates. It's me and my generation. It's me and my workplace, right? So by connecting those dots and kind of zooming out, you're giving that person a platform to talk about their book or something they've written, because let's face it, if they're, you know, a prominent person, they probably have published works and they probably have a mission. So use that reach and tell them, you know, we might have 50 people at this panel, but think about all the social media promotion we can do. People want to hear about your mission and your work, and give them a chance to really amplify the message.
Yeah, I feel like people just want the most bang for their buck, right? Like, if I'm going to show up to something, I want to know, will it be seen a few more places, or are more people going to see it? And there's nothing wrong with that. So I feel like you just want to make sure that you give them some specific numbers, or, you know, specifics around the reach as well.
And really add value, because you are that vessel that's allowing them to amplify the message.
I love that. All right, so to recap, when you're writing an email that you actually want someone to respond to, which is most of us, you want to follow Gloria's CPR method, and it stands for credibility, P for point of view, and R for reach. All right, well, Gloria, thank you so much for joining us today and sharing these amazing tips. And but one thing we haven't talked about is your career transition. You went from government to PR, and I know that you must have done something in between so that you could have this method. So tell us a little bit about that.
So very different, and I get asked that all the time. It's like, what? So random. But I will say that I failed time and time again. I've sent thousands of emails that have not been responded to. I've cold called people, newsrooms. And throughout all of my failures, I've picked up on the times when people have responded and when a response is initiated. And that's how I came up with this formula. I think it boils down to how much value you can give and what your intention is. Because a lot of times we're asking, we're basically telling them, I have my own agenda and I don't care about you. Please fulfill this need. Yeah. But when you're asking in this way, it's not so much about agenda, you know, driving your agenda. You're basically providing a platform for them to spread their message and also adding value.
Yeah, I love it. We really want to drive home, you need to add value.
Yes.
If you need some more networking help, download our free networking templates that you can copy and paste straight into your email drafts. That's linked in the description below. And be sure to check Gloria out on GloriaChowPR.com. You can also follow her on LinkedIn, and we've included all of that in the description below. And remember, we want to hear from you. What are your best tips for getting replies to your cold emails? Tell us in the comments below. Did you find this video helpful? If you did, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel because we drop videos weekly.